Hey guys, it's Jessica from craftinastampin.blogspot.com, and I got such an overwhelming response on my craft show goods to sell in my first miniseries. I decided to start a second miniseries. So we're going to have another 5-episode miniseries. It may not be every day. I'm shooting for every day, but my big craft show is this week, so I may have to be making projects for that, but we're going to see. If not, it's going to be like, it'll definitely be, but by the end of this week, all 5 episodes will be in, but I might have to skip a night. But anyway, so on to our first project that we're going to do, and it is, can you even see what that says? There we go. It is a mini note card holder. Everybody, when I showed this, I had a lot of people ask me, oh my gosh, how did you make that? So I wanted to just show you that I use the Snowhaven paper pack, as like I've been using for everything. I use some gold bling gems. These little mini pens you can get at Staples are really cheap and really cute. So let's just go right ahead and get started. So you're going to need one piece of solid cardstock cut at 7 3/8 inches long by 3 1/4 inches high. Once you get that done, we're going to go ahead and we're going to score this. Let me get my scoreboard. We're going to score it 3 1/8 inch. We're going to score it 3.5. And we're going to score it 3 7/8. Now, I have a few that I need to finish up. So I'm just going to pop them out real quick now. Okay. Perfect. So, we can put our scoreboard to the side. Done. Now, let's go ahead and we're going to fold on the 3.5 inch line. Okay. So once we fold on the 3.5 inch line, we're going to take a pair of scissors. Okay. So the 3.5 inch line, let me just show you real quick. We have the 3 1/8, 3.5, 3 7/8. Okay. You're going to fold on the 3.5 inch line and you're going to cut two little slices in between the 3.5 and the 3.5 and the 3 1/7 inch line. So right here, you see that? So I just folded in half, turned it, cut. Very easy. See, here's the one line, here's the next line. Okay, so see how I have a little holder now that'll come in handy for my pen. So what I'm actually going to do now is I'm going to flip this inside out, and I'm going to fold on my 3 7-inch line. And so I'm folding down, and then I'm going to get this 3.5-inch line, and it's going to come back. And then I'm going to get my 3 1/8-inch line and go forward. Just like this. Okay? So it actually looks like that. Now what we're going to do is we're going to get some sticky strip, and we're going to put sticky strip right above and right below the cut line. Oh, my sticky strip stuck to my table. Let's get rid of that piece. Okay, so we are going to go and we're going to put a piece there, put a piece right there. I went over a little bit. So you see how the sticky strip looks? I saved room. I obviously don't want to glue down where I made the little cuts. Okay? It's going to fold in like this and stay folded in, and then this becomes our little door for our little booklet and then the little holder for our pen. It's super easy. And depending on how you decorate them, could be very easy, very cute, not time consuming at all. Like I said, it just is going to depend on how you feel like decorating. Now, I'm going to be using the, come on, there it goes. I'm going to be using the holiday tag stamp set, and I already went ahead and I cut out some of the pieces. Hold on, let me get this folded down. Okay. So there we go. We're all ready to go. We're all sitting up. Now, what we're going to need is we're going to need two layer pieces. And I am using White Daisy, and it's cut at 3 inches wide by 2 3/4 inch high. And then the Snowhaven decorating piece is 2 3/4 inch wide by 3 1/2 inches wide. Now I'm just going to go ahead. Oh, what happened there? What is going on here? Am I doing this upside down? There it goes. Guess I was going too quick for it. I don't often use this one. I haven't at least lately. There we go. I just needed it in a jam the other day. So it was on my craft table. Okay. So we have that all done. Now we're just going to go ahead and get it adhered onto the front of our little mini book we made. Okay. So we have that on. Now, like I was saying, I already went ahead and I used the holiday tag stamp set, which is right here. It is D1560 holiday tags, and they have all different little cute brackets and sayings and whatnot. They have Happy Holidays, Merry Christmas, Happy Thanksgiving, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Birthday, Happy Holidays, Happy Halloween, Happy Mother's Day, Happy Father's Day, Happy Valentine's Day, Merry Christmas. They have so many of them on here. It's awesome. So what I'm going to do is, like I said, I already cut out the one and I already stamped it. This is the glacier. Why can you not see this? There we go. Is it that it really is too bright in here? Oh, much better. Okay. This is the glacier ink that I already stamped on a few of them to get them ready to go. And now what I want to do is I want to take the stamp set, and I think I'm going to do Happy Hanukkah, Happy Holidays, Merry Christmas. I'm going to do a few of them. So let's get Happy Holidays. Let's find, oh my gosh, my stamps are crazy messy right now. Jesus. Oh, there we go. Okay, so let's get our... Where's Glacier? There we go. My Glacier ink. And there's my Happy Holidays. I'm just going to push it in. And I'm just going to stamp it on. How cute is that? Happy Holidays. Love it. Okay, so let's go ahead and get it adhered to the front of our little book that we made. My gosh, come on. There we go. And now let's use some of our wine gems, if I could find them. That's what I did with them. Here we go. Take a little bling gem, just stick it at the bottom. Now what we need to do is we need to get our little pen. So let me just borrow it out of this other one. And we're just going to slide it right on down. You might have to wiggle it around a little bit to make sure it fits, but it'll get in there. And there you go. Now, hold on 1 second, baby. Now the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take our... That's Bubba. He's saying good morning. Take our Post-it notes and... We are going to add some sticky strip to the back of that, so that way it stays inside our little holder. I You don't need to do a ton, just some on the top and some on the bottom. Okay. And you just want to, I always get my scoring tool and just reinforce it on there. So that way it stays on. And then take it off. Just like this. Okay, now that we have the sticky strip on the back side of that, we can just put it right inside our little book here. Okay. Sorry, I had to do mine back a little bit so I can make sure it was straight. And there you have it. That's how you make the little mini notepad holders. Aren't they so cute? So cute and so easy to make. And they make a really fun gift. Now, if you wanted to put them inside one of the little plastic baggies, you can make an insert. Let's see. You could do a bag that's 3x4. Four by four, little 4x4 bags, a little baggie, stick it inside there. Maybe a little snug. No, it won't. It shouldn't be. A little 4x4 baggie, and then you can do like a little topper. Cut it 4¾ by 3½, and then score at 1.75 along the 3½ line. And then it could sit inside a little baggie. I'll have them done later, and I'll try and post pictures on my blog with it. In the meantime, yeah, that's it. So make sure you stop by my blog and my YouTube channel for the next few days to see what else I show you. And I hope that it helps you guys out in your craft show fair this holiday season. So thank you so much for watching. I hope to catch you crafting and stamping. Bye.